What's up, guys? G.I. Joe here. We are back with Guild Wars 1 gameplay. And I got a ton of characters. This is a really old game, but I used to play it all the time in college. And let's go check out the town before it turns Halloween. So let's go, my main guy, and go. This thing's got a few things to do. And this is what the town looks like. Before the event begins, there's a few people actually on. People still do play, just not that many on right now, but give or take when it does go live here tomorrow, the districts will be probably about 6, 7, 8 of them. They'll all be full. The players that do play will come on, and they like to park their characters and do this kind of stuff, but let's get a little more festive, and I'll just kind of show you around what this place looks like. I used to play this in 2005, September of 2005. My cousin got me into it, and that'd be Ryan. And yeah, it's just one of the towns, outposts. He's got like storage over here, just different stuff. I've always liked the scenery of the stuff, but people transform into different stuff. It's pretty spooky, but I'm just going to show you a little tour around just this main city, iconic city of the series. And then we'll do the same thing for Lion's Arch when the decorations do come back. And they last from, I think, the 18th of October through the 31st, but I think they hang around for a few days after, like November 2nd or 3rd or so, and then they go away, and they won't be back for another year, you know, so that's how that is. But yeah, the map of Tyria, which is pretty big. I think this entire game is, there's a ton of content, a lot of story in it, but, there's prophecies, there's, what is it, Cantha. You can actually go travel here, the other continents here, and I'll actually show those cities on, I think, Cantha doesn't really celebrate it, but, if we go to Kamadan, you know, that's a different story, but there's also, Eye of the North was the other expansion. I think there's a total of 3 expansions for this game, and it went all the way through, like, 2009, 2010 or something. But yeah, all this stuff is gonna change, so we'll show you that here in a few minutes. But just wanted to kind of do a little bit of a tour. I've always wanted to do this with this game, just kind of make a video. And there's the keep, Lion's Arch Keep, and Mad King, like in Guild Wars 2, comes in this one, and this Mad King says pretty much the same stuff. But, yeah, I'm just about done showing you everything. This gets kind of spooky out here as well. I don't even know how much stuff I got, like, hardly anything. The fact that they don't have capes in 2 is really weird, because we got them in 1. We've always worn them, but they just never include them. See, I have, like, 20 plat to my name. I don't even have any ectos anymore. Spent everything I had. I did have 1 million at one time, but yeah, let's go to some of the other cities real quick. The main 2 here is Drachnar's Forge. Go there, just look around a second. Yeah, just a dwarven town, little dwarf dudes. But yeah, like I was trying to say earlier, this game is on Steam, and you can get all the expansions. I think it may be $20. You can probably beat the game with henchmen, and henchmen are just computer-controlled people that you recruit, and they get a share of the loot and stuff. But I think they're up this way. Yeah, there's the henchman over there. You just kind of click them and add them to your thing. You kick them. You have up to 8, but depending on the map, you can have like 6. But yeah, this place gets a little bit of a makeover as well. There's Glint's little statue thing. This will probably be about an hour long video, I'm not really sure, but I'm just going to kind of go into detail of the scenery, because I never know when they're going to actually, how long this game will be up. I'd like to have a little memoir of how the game was, because it has been up since 05 and, what is it, 2019 now? About to be 2020. Yeah, it's about to be 15 years old, so it's as old as WoW, so. And the people that made this game came from the WoW studio, I believe, Mike O'Brien or some of the guys. But yeah, I think there's a ship to Cantha or something. But yeah, that's pretty much all there is, Drowner's Forge. And of course, all these towns and cities are able to be found in the second game after 200 years when the Elder Dragons wake up. But yeah, that's Draknar's. We'll go to Tombs of Primeval Kings. And, oh my god. This place also gets a huge makeover. And this was just a little, a dungeon place you could go do stuff. I've never really played it much. I went a few times, just can't remember, but it's so long ago. I wasn't one of the in-game kind of people, I just PvE, but this is PvE, but I think it builds on the world. There's a Chaos Axe and Ghostly Hero guy. Kind of reminds me of Beetlejuice out here or something, like sandworms or something. Kind of spooky. But yeah, we'll come back here at a different time to see the scenery, but let's go to Kamadon, and then we will, after showing that, we will warp to the Halloween festivities. So lots of different towns, and these are the main ones that do get decorated, I believe. People are here. A lot of people are in Kamadon. And yeah, you can dance in this game and do all kinds of stuff. I got pink dye on because it's breast cancer month. But that's just what they give you. That vendor just becomes a thing this month in October. But yeah, this city is just sort of, it's bigger than Lion's Arch, I think, or maybe about the same size. Yeah. Well, we'll warp to the event and just show you around and maybe show you some of the stuff, the items that you can get. So we'll see in a second. Here's Kamadon. I guess we'll tour it first. Since I forgot I logged out here. As you can see, everyone's been transformed and stuff. They got decorations going. Also hear some cool audio and stuff. Horseman. One of the Ettins in the game. Ghost. my character's set to max height, so I really can't look through that. Got some toilet paper, which people are really doing around here right now, just throwing them everywhere, like they always do. This little bit doesn't get transformed, but... Get some graves out here. Like somebody coming out of the grave. Another one. Just wanted to kind of go into the detail of the decorations of all the towns. Spooky hand, and we'll cross this bridge and we'll double back. Thing. And if my Guild Wars 2 video is up, you can kind of see how the original hat stacks up to the one from 2. You can actually dye the one from 2. This one you really can't dye, I don't think. Though you may can. Spooky ship out here. Can't really board it, but some ghosts flying around. Pirate flag. Can't use skills in town either. Came through here already, but also there's a rope, hanging rope there, coffins, that's one of the classes that's not in Guild Wars 2 is the dervish. They use size and stuff. Also have special outfits. This mushroom-looking place where the Mad King spawns, you can actually talk to his henchmen, they'll turn around, but they stand up when he arrives on the 31st. I think it's the 30th, like midnight, 2 a.m. where I live. There's a little bitty pumpkin and some kind of backdrop for a haunted house somebody put in. The moon, you can kind of tell, is the same as the second one. Same graphic, though it probably looks more high resolution. Got a guillotine here. No, it doesn't work, but model for one. Some kind of leatherworking station. Another one of these horseman guys. I used to farm the stuff to get these. I show them in Lion's Arch what kind of party favors you can get. Mad King Steward, you can get quests to do in the underworld. 50 trick-or-treat bags, 5k experience, and you get transmogrifer tonics. Something wicked this way comes. More transformed Alonians. There's also some quests here. Lots of different quests to get type bags. Which we were farming those in 2. I farm about 250 a day. You get about 13, 14 gold a piece. There's somebody with a tonic on. I don't know who the heck is doing that. But that is pretty much it for Chromadon. There's one place we didn't go. Let me go over here really quick. That's the thing making all the noise, the hellhound. Up here's just a little bit of stuff, I think. Another horseman collecting something else. He's collecting carapaces. Mandragore carapaces I used to farm all the time. I get like thousands of those things turning in. A bunch of candles everywhere. You can kind of notice in, they do this in twosome as well. No matter what angle you look at these from, it's a 2D image, but it just, it will face you, always face you. And it's just like a candle, so. This is 2005 plus graphics, so. Back when I was still a teenager. Yeah, that just about covers this place, guys. So let's port over to... This is Alona, by the way. The Cantha. I might show it last, but let's get Lion's Arch and all the other towns out of the way. Okay, if you remember, this was a fountain here. This is the big cauldron. Bones and stuff and ghosts flying everywhere. Bats. Somebody is a kraken. And same ring for the Mad King. Has the guards here. I don't know why they are not in the second game. There's an underworld, I forget what you call this thing. Undying Nightmare, I think is what they're called. They would unenchant you if you're trying to run a 55 month. And only those who play Guild Wars know what I'm talking about. But Mini Mad King, just different NPCs have been changed just like before. Same Mad Moon, and there's bats and the clouds. You can kind of make out some shapes of what stuff is. Like that's a scythe, it's a face of some sort. Another face. I think that's a witch. One of these is a witch, I forget which one. It's a lot of witches. Let's see. Yeah, Mad King spawns right in front of that cauldron, and out here everything's been... People have been transformed. It's like Alona. And this used to be like the peak of MMOs 15 years ago. It's amazing to see what has changed. The lion has an axe invented, just one of them does. And over here they're collecting different stuff, glowing hearts from fire imps. Somebody's been transformed into a char. The char look a lot different in this, in the original game. Henchmen don't really get affected. There's a hellhound. This guy over here. He's like a... I don't know what he is, really. Tormented something. And... That's another skills guy. They got a big pit of bones in it. Bodies and stuff, skulls. That's Bone Dragon. I got a mini one of those somewhere here. Miniature Bone Dragon. There it is. That was once one of the most expensive miniatures you could get in the game. I just happened to look out and get it here a few years ago. But yeah, everything has changed out here. The sea has turned a eerie green. There's some bodies on some boats out here. Nothing that way. You can't really go in the water like you can into. You could swim into underwater combat. Go anywhere into just about. The pier has big giant bones surrounding it. There's some fish swimming around out here, but I think they're also present in, when it's not Halloween anyway. Bat swooping down. We got ghost out here, the pirate ship. And here is a ghost lady. I mean, the models look pretty good in this game, considering how old it is. There goes the big fish out there, swimming around. Pirate ship, and here is a gargoyle. Sunken ship out that way. And the lighthouse has changed as well. The ghosts are flying around. Lots of ghosts flying right by us. And everywhere else they want to go. Okay, when we're done with this area, let's go around. Look at the lion. It's got like a giant skull on it. I don't know what that is. It's kind of freaky. Over here got some dead palm trees. The keep looks creepy as crap. Yeah, that over there, I'll show you that in a minute. There's a guy on the ground. The gargoyle. Got a few little pumpkins laying around. I guess that's like a forge. These guys have been skeletized. They're just NPC merchants. Okay, let's head back to the main part again. Cover the last little area out here. And District 1 so far, when it gets close to Halloween, there's like 6-7 districts. There used to be like 20 back in when this game was in its prime. But yeah. A lot of people still play. More of the same out here. We got body, bones and stuff earlier. And I got a bunch of pumpkins. Stuff around the base of this thing. Another pit. This guy gives quests, I think. And these guys are wrapped up like mummies. It's actually like spider web or whatever. It's like the main area where you would buy your different stuff, like runes, basic mats, rare mats, things of that sort. You can still kind of get in a little cage out here. Little thing we used to do. Over here's not much. We're gonna Drachnar's after this. And everybody's just kind of... Somebody took a tonic to look at Char. This music's pretty cool. rasping dude. This is gonna be probably pretty loud when I do this, but one of these guys that are like the ghost in the box. He lets you do your cape colors and stuff. That's the keep entrance over there. This guy, I don't know what he is. He's a guild registrar guy. One time I spammed like the videos on my account somewhere. YouTube account where I spammed a ton of ghosts and lagged the server. That's a ghost in the box. And yeah, I spawned a ton of them things. You cannot do more than one anymore. You used to just do them constantly. Squash serum. What else we got? That's just the trick-or-treat bags. Whatever you get, you get. Candy corn tonic. I got a birthday present voucher. I might go redeem that here in a second. Vial of absinthe. And a witch's brew. Makes everything kind of hazy. Funky. Alcoholic drink. But, yeah, there's a guy right here that used to, you can see his body, now you can't. Yeah, he's supposed to be there, but he's not. But he says different stuff when you step on him. You can see those hats are different times of the year. And they don't release any new hats, so that's just a thing of the past. You can still get them, though. It's just when your birthday comes, you talk to this guy here. And you can get minis this way, but the hat guy's over there. I'll show him in a second. Let's go with 7th, because you can get any gift possible with this one. So let's see what we get. Oh wow, that one I could probably sell for a lot. I got 2 of those now. So I might try to sell that and get some more platinum. As you can see, I'm kind of low. But yeah, this person... Where are they? There was a person here. There we go. Ludor, this guy. You can get any of the hats that you've unlocked. I've unlocked about all of them. Okay, well let's travel to one of the last places. Just Drachnar's really quick. If I could click on it. Then we'll go to Primeval Kings. Take a look at that. Awesome centerpiece skull with a candle milled on it. Same moon, got the ghost flying everywhere, and there's a pirate ship doctor as well. Pretty much the same kind of stuff. Candles, pumpkins everywhere. Horsemen collecting stuff. This one's collecting summit badges from the dwarves. I forget what they're called. Stone Summit, I think. Stone Summit badges, yeah. Here's not much of anything. Those gigantic archways are in 2. They're flooded, though. Where Drachnar's used to be. And here's some graves and stuff, candles. nothing much out here. Just I don't think you can board that ship, so Draknar's a little underwhelming, not as much stuff here. Alright, let's go to Tombs of Primeval Kings. And we'll check that out next. There's a different kind of moon here. It's a skull. Crazy looking skull. Same ghost. It's got... It's not that big of an outpost. Just a few little decorations. Got the cauldrons. They got two of them on this place. You kind of see down into the... on this map too. Whereas you cannot in Lion's Arch. Just a bunch of bones. Inside there. I don't know if there's anything out here or not. Well, it looked to be. Basically it, as far as decorations guys, just wanted to show you. We'll go to Mad King Says next. Alright, this district one is full as can be, look at all these names. Scissors are the games, and Mad King Says, Simon Says. So yeah, it's pretty late actually, it's 4 p.m. It's like the next to last time that he comes on 31st, at least in my time, Central Time. The last time he comes for me is 2 a.m. I missed the 8 p.m. Busy playing other games. Paula just died. Actually, hit the stupid Windows key and not have to sleep. And it messed up everything, so there we go. But he will kill you in this game. In this game, well, two of you don't actually. A lot of AFKers around here. They just leave their character in the ring all day and get hot, pretty much. Weird. That goes way too long. districts. You know, back in the old days, districts used to be really high. Not everybody can fit the same map before. Thank you. stint was a lot shorter, but